All right. The sense this crowd's kind of small and they all go to the same school here, you probably know what happened to me, but I figure I should explain how I sound. It's called aphasia. It's a thing that happens when you're brain damaged and you sound like a fucking retard. Yeah, I know it. It's no problem, really. It's kind of funny watching the faces of the people I start talking to who have never talked to me before. First, it's like the whites of their eyes go extra white. Like, I call that phase of shock and fear. It's like, oh, what do I do? Do I give him money? I show him the way home. See if he has a cell phone I can call his mother for him. But, you know, that doesn't last too long. That gives away quick to the buddy stage. That's where I noticed this first with townies around here. But it seems to be in the city too. This is where people start calling me buddy. They're my buddy. Yeah, and oh, it makes me so angry. Because, like, I'll tell you, hey, listen, I ain't your buddy. I ain't never been your buddy. And I ain't never gonna be the buddy of a shit-kicking son of a bitch like you. But I don't do that, because I'm a nice guy. I do that. I'm a good guy, you know, but recently I've also been noticing there's some ways I'm not so nice. Like, any fans of Pop-Tarts out there? No one else? Alright, I'll pretend. Okay, any fans of Pop-Tarts out there? Well, what's your favorite flavor?
S'mores.
Strawberry.
S'mores? Fuck you. What do you eat? Jesus, that's like sugary children's serum. And cherry, it's like bug paste. There's only one flavor. What is it?
S'mores.
Cinnamon.
Strawberry.
That's right, brown sugar cinnamon. You got it. And also, I've become far more judgmental about my pronunciations. For instance, I say tomato, you say tomato. No. I say tomato, you don't speak English. Look it up in the dictionary, motherfucker. But I just get angry at imaginary people sometimes. another thing I've been doing, I've been writing a lot of Yo Mama jokes recently. Like, I've got some Buddhist Yo Mama jokes. Like, your mama is so fat, she don't take the eightfold path, she takes the noble 32-fold path. Yeah. And 8 times 4 is 32. That means she's like as fat as 4 Buddhas. You seen those statues, she'd have to be like an orb. But, of course, that's not my worst Yo Mama joke at all. There's another joke I'm nervous about telling, my worst Yo Mama joke. I'm gonna do it. I've just gotta... Alright, no, I'll just do it. Okay, Yo Mama was so fat. See, you already know it's gonna be bad because it was. Your mama was so fat, she had a heart attack, she probably would have made it. You probably don't quite get that, but it'll make sense when I tell you what inspired it. That joke was inspired by the Trail of Tears.
Oh.
Yeah. That's not good, man. That's no good. I can't help it that I thought of it and had to type it into my computer. I can't help that. But, you know, being insensitive like this, you know, it doesn't help me with the ladies, which I can tell by your laughter. I probably wasn't doing too well with them anyway. But, you know, I've been thinking, you know, maybe I should meet a blind chick. No, deaf. Sorry. A deaf chick, because so my voice wouldn't have any influence. So let me just... Are there any deaf chicks in the audience? Get it? Because I was turned around and couldn't read my lips. And they couldn't hear it because they're deaf. But, you know, I had a fantasy that I can't do now, but I once had a fantasy, start dating a blind girl. Just, I don't know, go to the blind supermarket or wherever they hang out. And go troubling for blind chicks and bring one home and, you know, have a nice meal like prime rib or something. Then put on some music and then while she's sitting there completely unaware, do the nastiest, most disgusting striptease we've ever seen. Like, butt cheeks apart and everything. Thank you, I've been Andrew Holton.